Back in the action here at Shamrock Fighting Championships, Jeremy Johnson along with Shamrock FC President Jesse Finney. Coming up next, it is Jesse Conway taking on Devin Miller.
Please welcome to the cage, Devin Miller.
Making his way to the cage by way of Team Fusion, it is Devin Miller out of Springfield, Missouri. Now coming off a big win in his last outing, he was able to finish by referee stoppage in only a minute and 55 seconds. Now this high school wrestler says that tonight he wants to show part of his stand-up, keep this fight on its feet and use his distance as he is quite a bit taller than his opponent. Now I found this funny, everyone called him Post Malone in the weigh-ins. He says, tonight I'm gonna put on a show.
I don't argue there, buddy.
At all. He also came up a weight class for this fight, says that the cut was much easier and he feels much stronger.
And his opponent, Jesse Conway.
Coming to us by way of St. Charles MMA and sporting a perfect wrestler record, excuse me. The college wrestler in Jesse Conway looks to get this fight to the ground. That first win came by referee stoppage in round one. Now Jesse actually works for one of our sponsors at Supplement Superstores. One of the coaches walked in, saw him, goes, hey man, you have kind of messed up ears. You ever want to fight mixed martial arts? He said, let's give this a try.
I love it, I love it.
Those Supplement Superstores guys put out great talent. As we go to our tail of the tape, Jesse Conway, 26 years old, 5'7", 154.2 pounds. Devin Miller, 23 years old, 5'10", 155.6 pounds.
What I'll tell you, Jeremy, is with Team Fusion down there in Springfield, Missouri, they're building quite a little team down there. All their guys, they always come hard to fight, and they got pretty slick jiu-jitsu. And you know what? They're good guys to deal with as well because they always come hard, they always come to fight. But then again, you got someone like Devin Miller who comes out of St. Charles MMA. You know if he's going to be coming out of St. Charles, he's probably a grinding, heavy, hard wrestler. He's going to come out strong and fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is set for three rounds in the Shamrock Fighting Championships lightweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the Metro by T-Mobile, Blue Corner. A mixed martial artist that stands 5'10" tall. He weighed in officially 155.6 pounds. Fighting out of Springfield, Missouri, Devin Miller. Across the cage, his opponent fighting out of the Metro by T-Mobile Red Corner. This fighter stands 5'7" tall. Official weight, 154.2 pounds. Fighting out of St. Charles, Missouri, Jesse Conway.
Referee Dwayne Bess has the call for this contest. This fight is three-minute rounds in the Shamrock FC lightweight division. Jesse Conway in the red tape, Devin Miller in the blue. Miller quickly trying to establish the jab.
Oh,
eats
right
a big
hand.
Right hand. Jesse Conway looks in amazing shape.
Really does. He's very calm. He's got a good kicks. Throwing crisp, hard punches.
He's doing very well here to cutting down the cage on Miller.
Miller needs to work off the jab a little bit more. He's waiting on Conway to come after him a little bit.
Yeah, he's almost playing the role of counterpuncher here.
He really is, and he's probably 6 inches taller. That's a bad strategy.
Big shot there out of the Lindenwood College wrestler. Looking at a potential reverse triangle here. Devin Miller on top, though. Nice sweep out there from Jesse Conway, controlling that ankle, looking to pull him down.
Miller needs to attack his left hand and pull it out because it's the only way to post up and stand back up. Now he's trying to switch over.
Good top pressure here out of Conway. So Jesse, what did you prefer, kickboxing or MMA?
Interesting. What I really preferred is not to be on bottom like here, like Miller. He's got tight jiu-jitsu right here. He's really snug. It just doesn't surprise me. These guys have had a great camp over there at St. Charles Uemme. Refugee, he's high. He needs to attack the head and pull him over.
Conway are trying to flatten him out, looking for that rear naked choke.
He needs to go Devin 2-on-1. He's fighting, got that.
Fighting the hands there, trying to get that Post Malone braid out of the way. Down to under halfway through the first round here. Good scramble here. Adam Miller trying to turn into Conway.
That's good. I'm telling you, Fusion, these guys down there, they're producing some great guys. They really are. Every guy that always came up to Shamrock FC for us, man, they always come hard to fight. And I really, they're a new camp coming up.
Miller trying to buck his hips and get out, but the wrestling here out of Jesse Conway. Again, takes heavy, the back.
Heavy pressure right here. If I'm Conway's coach, I'm telling him to get his right hook in right here, and I'm telling him to flatten him out. Don't really worry about the choke as much. He's got real heavy top position. There's the hook. He's trying to put it in. Now, I wouldn't even worry about the hook. I would take his back and just flatten. Well, he's doing it.
In Jesse Conway's corner, UFC veteran Josh Sampo. A good wrestler himself.
Oh, absolutely. UFC, Bellator veteran, and Josh Sampo. And you know what? This guy, Conway does remind me a little bit of him. He's short. He's got good right hand. He's got crisp boxing. And he's got a heavy top game pressure for wrestling and high level jiu-jitsu in Josh Sampo.
10 seconds remaining here in this first round.
Good fight.
Oh, big up kick at the end. Lost a contact lens, it looked like.
I thought he was thugging, he got kicked in the face, and it was actually, he's looking for his contact here. Great, good first round, buddy.
Good first round. How do you call that one?
I got to give that fight, I give that round to Conway right here. You know, but what you find out with a lot of these heavy wrestlers, that they're pretty green. A lot of them fade towards the end, but I did not see whatsoever any fading going on from Conway there. See, right here, if he's in the full mount, he probably should have brought his hips up a little bit higher and tried to grind upon and get his knees under his armpits and pound away.
Good action there from the Mattingly Lumber instant replay. Again, as we see Rob Washington and Josh Sampo in the corner of Jesse Conway. Devin Miller finishing up there.
Devin Miller really has to establish a jab. You know that Conway's gonna come and he's gonna try to shoot an inside single or a blast double. I would drop my stance if I am Devin Miller, and I'm gonna work off my jab and wait for a good right uppercut.
Second round underway. Jesse Conway in the red tape. Devin Miller in the blue.
See, now he did it. He did it right there, I will say. But good coaching from his corner right there.
But Miller is kind of leading that jab with his chin up.
He goes for an inside single. But if I'm Conway, I'm doing that. I'm going to step over. There you go. Turn the corner right there. Make him earn it. You got to stay busy, or this wrestler's going to grind you out.
This is never a good position for Devin Miller, being on the bottom against a top-heavy wrestler, looking at the scarf lock position here.
If I'm Conway, I'm going to say, do not lose your left underhook. Stay heavy with it. Look for a crucifix. Switch your hips over and pound away.
Good side control position coming out of Conway. Just doing his best to be heavy. Not a lot of damage being done, but out wrestling Miller.
But the problem is, Jeremy, with this is, yeah, he's winning the round. There you go. Now he's got the underhook. He's going to fire away. This is what he really needs to be starting to drop some bombs a little bit. You know, a lot of wrestlers are not real excited about taking a full mount position. They'll take the side control and they'll dominate the whole fight. And what he's doing right here, the first minute and a half, he's complete domination in this.
Halfway through the second round, as you said, stepping here over into mount now.
He needs to get his knees under his armpits and pound away.
Working that grapevine position from the top.
Miller's got to get on a hip and create some space. There you go.
Big That's what you bomb gotta, drop there from gonna, Jesse Conway.
He's got to do something with it, though, Jeremy. That's good. He's got to give me 6 or 8 of those.
Down to under 1 minute remaining here in the second round. Conway also right in front of his corner here. How big is that to be able to hear your corner in a position like this, especially for some of the younger guys?
It's huge. And you know what? It's not just that you're listening for advice. You're also got comfort. A lot of these guys, I don't know how old Conway is, but I would say Conway, he's probably 23, 24 years old maybe. You know, to have someone like a Josh Sapp and a Rob Washington in your corner, you know, that's a huge advantage. And then you're right in front of them. Just makes you keep your ears open.
More ground and pound from the top position.
He's got it, but you know what, Jeremy? He's got to get the knees on the armpits, buddy. He's got to get the knees on the armpits and posture up. And if he does that and he hits him 4 to 6, 10 times, something along those lines, the referee Dwayne Best will jump in and stop the fight.
10 seconds left here in the second round. More ground and pound here out of Conway. Conway finishes that round in a very dominant top position. So if you are in the corner here of Devin Miller, what has he got to do? One, he has to finish this fight.
Absolutely. He's down 2-0, Jeremy, no matter what, how to enter on the scorecards. What I tell him right here is, hey, listen, you're down 2-0. You're going to have to get a finish. You're going to have to get a finish. You're going to maybe get a 10-8. You're going to get a tie. You're going to get a draw. No. I'm saying, listen, you're going to go for broke, son. You're going to keep your jab long. You're going to keep a jab long, but you don't have to step on every jab, Jeremy, because that's how he's getting an inside single. He's stepping on the jab, and then what's happening is Conway's exploding in and getting a single. He can keep long on his jab without stepping. Do not move your feet. Keep the jab rolling. Wait for the right uppercut to come fly, and when it flies, come back with a short left hook. Cut the angle, and he has to cut the angle. If he does not cut the angle, he's going to stay right in his face, and he will keep driving on that inside single.
Third and final round. Jesse Conway in the red. Devin Miller in the blue.
See, Jeremy. He's working off the jab, trying the uppercut.
Miller eats a big right hand, though.
Well, what he needs to do when he throws that jab, he needs to bring it back to his cheek or he's going to get knocked out, too. I really would not be going to get a kick in the third round here, but
not against a wrestler like this.
Not against a wrestler. You're on one leg. You're already down two, and that's what's going to happen.
Big duck under.
Do not. He's got to get up. Don't fight from your knees, son. You got to get up. There you go.
Nice sprawl there, though.
What I said earlier, Jeremy, a lot of these guys, man. You know what? These dominant heavy wrestlers, they fade in the third, and then, younger guys like this. Now, is he fading? Of course, he is fading a little bit. But Devin Miller has to take advantage of this. And he's got to finish him, because if not, even if he loses this round, he's still going to lose the fight 29-28.
Yeah, Miller throws a big uppercut there and misses, but he is looking to finish with each punch now.
He's going to try to drive him to the cage. He's going to try to drop down and get a double there.
Again, nice uppercut landing for Miller.
He's cut. Yes. He's got to get the legs back. Now, see, that's the domination of a pure wrestler right there, buddy. He's got to step over to his left, get a far side right underhook, grip the shoulder. He's going to stall out for about a minute. If I'm his coach, that's exactly what I'd tell him. I would say keep your right underhook, pull him up, posture up and punch and steal the round. I would not lose that right underhook. Because what's going to happen right here is Miller needs to create the space to get the left underhook. And they blocked him back off. That's good.
Jesse Conway here, dominant position, potentially stealing that round with that shot. Now takes the back of Devin Miller, looking to flatten him out again. Gets the hooks in.
Now, Jeremy, what people don't understand and have been in this position is you have a wrestler like Conway on top of you. He needs to get his arms in the back of Miller's armpits, flatten him out, and use his cup to his advantage. People think, well, the cup. No, you need to drive the cup in the back of someone's back. It's extremely painful.
Looking for that rear naked choke, fighting the 2-on-1 from the bottom here.
Good fight. A very good fight for both of these guys, long term.
Miller does the correct thing, turns into Conway here.
If I'm Conway's coach, what I'm telling him is get your knees up in his armpits. You got 20 seconds left in the fight. Yes, you're going to win the fight. But you know what? You're also working on some things right here as well.
Pushing me. Down to 10 seconds remaining here in the fight.
Once again, Jeremy, both these guys coming out of good camp, St. Charles MMA and Fusion down in Springfield, Missouri. I'm proud of both these guys.
Big one for both of these guys here. A beautiful fight as Conway makes his back to his feet. A little cut there over the left eye as we see Cutman Craig here for Shamrock working on it. Devin Miller hanging on to his coach. What a fight from these two. Let's send this one up to the cage to Joe Parisi to make it official.
Rounds, we turn this one over to the judges, where tonight we have unanimous decision. Tonight's winner out of the red corner, Jesse Conway.
A big win for Jesse Conway, adding another one to his record here at Shamrock FC. Both of these young guys look very good though in this fight. We still have more action to come here at Shamrock Fighting Championships 311, and we will be right back right after this.